Hello everyone, I am Emeric Blom, and in this video, I will present the paper Uniform Edit Selection for Genetic Improvement, Empirical Analysis of Mutation Operator Efficacy. This work follows the master project of Marta Smigilska, a student at the University College London, supervised by myself and Justina Patker. Genetic Improvement, or GI, is all about improving existing software. There are many ways to evolve a given software. Some approaches evolve it as a whole. Some focus on intermediary representations, such as, for example, diff patches, but nowadays many GI work are based on edit sequences. Edits, most usually deletions, replacements, or insertions, for examples of lines of code or statement in the software IST, are the most common types of edits. They are easy to generate, easy to manipulate, and they provide a compact representation for program variants. To obtain the modified variant, one only needs to start from the original software and apply in order the different edits. The one central question we ask is then how to best generate the GI edits. In what we will call the standard way to generate GI edits, due to its very frequent use, edits are created in two steps. First, the type of edit is chosen at random, so for example with the usual three types probabilities of 1/3, 1/3, 1/3, and only then genetic material is also generated sampled uniformly at random to actually construct the edit. While this strategy is seemingly well uniform, if we look closer at the number of possible edits of each type, it is clear that not all edits are generated equally. Because the number of possible deletions grows linearly, while the number of possible replacements or possible insertions grow quadratically, generated edits in equal proportion mean that edits from smaller edit spaces have a larger probability to be generated. With the usual three edit types, that means that deletion edits are way overrepresented. To avoid that, we propose a different way to generate GI edits. So first, what we want to do is count all the possible edits. So again, with our example with n lines, we said that to simplify, there is exactly n possible deletions, n square possible replacements, and n square possible insertions. So that means that in total, there is n plus 2n square possible edits. What we will do is adjust the weight according to which the type of the edit is sampled, so that every possible edit has the same probability to be generated. So with this simplified example, that would mean that instead of 1/3, 1/3, 1/3, we would mean n over the sum, n square over the sum, and n square over the sum. That will have the consequence that every single edit has the exact same probabilities to be generated. So there is no more over-representation of edit space whose have less possible edits in them. To compare these two ways of generating GI edits, we will consider 27 programs from the QuickBugs benchmark. So these are all short programs written in Java that all contain a single bug. QuickBugs provide correct and incorrect test cases that we will use to guide the search, which will be a local search with 500 steps. All the experiments are repeated 20 times. And we use four types of edits: the three usual statements, deletion, replacement, and insertion, and one more, the comparison operator replacement, that takes one of the following six operators and replaces it with another one. So that would mean that with the standard approach, all four types of edits has one fourth probability to be chosen. Here is one of the simplest programs of the QuickBugs challenge. There is a single function, and it doesn't work. We use SourceML to access the program IST, which provides us with five statements, a declaration statement, a while loop, two expression statements and a return, as well as a comparison operator. In the original challenge, you would have had 1 minute to find the bug. Instead, we use a local search on four types of edits. We ask two research questions. First, we want to compare the two ways of generating GI edits. We want to know the difference between uniformly selecting the type of edit and uniformly sampling within all unique edits. Then, we want to leverage our search to perform landscape analysis on our GA scenarios. In particular, we are interested in seeing emerging patterns between the type of edits and the ingredient types. In this table, we show the overall results of our experiments. Within the 27 selected quick search programs, the standard strategy leads to 8 fixed programs, whereas the uniform strategy leads to only 7 fixed programs. However, when we compare these results to a recent survey on QuickSpot Repair that compared 10 state-of-the-art automatic program repair tools, we can see that 3 of the programs, Kaip, Sort, Pascal, and Sys, has not been solved before by an automatic program repair tool. Furthermore, 2 of the programs, Knapsack and Merschorf, are only solved by 1 of the 10 automatic program repair tools. This is mainly due to the use of the comparison operator replacement in addition of the usual deletion, replacement, and insertion. We show here more detailed results. For the structural stages, we show, within the 20 repetitions, how many patches were found and how many within those patches are unique. We also show the number of iterations that are needed to find a patch. The standard strategies is seemingly more efficient than the uniform strategies. It finds in average 2 more patches, 1 more unique patch, and it does it within 133 iterations in comparison to 257, so twice as fast. The result seems clear. The uniform strategy finds fewer patches and fewer unique patches, and does it much slower than the standard strategy. However, the comparison doesn't stop here. If we look at individual programs, we can make very interesting observations. Programs that can be fixed using deletions or operation replacements are better fixed using the standard strategies. However, programs that require a statement replacement or statement insertions are better fixed using the uniform strategies. Overall, depending on the type of bugs a program exposes, the standard or uniform strategies will be more efficient depending on the probability of generating a specific edit. Here, we show the composition of patches found by the 2 strategies. First, we note that deletion is by far the least common edit. Even for the standard strategies, in which they are over-represented, deletions only compose 12% of the 73 edits. More surprising, even, for the uniform strategy, none of the 49 edits are a deletion. Then we note the very high percentage of operator replacements found by the standard strategies. This can be explained by the size of the edit space, which is even smaller than the space for deletions, meaning that this space is even more represented than deletions. Finally, we found that when uniformly sampling edits, replacement rather than deletion is the more common type of edit. Here, we show statistics obtained during the run of the uniform strategy. We can first see that the number of samples is directly correspond to the size of the relative edit space rather than being evenly distributed. The first observation is that insertion and replacements are the most crash-prone edit, with only 20% and 30% of edit generation that lead to a program variant that does not crash. For deletion, roughly half of the program variants crash, or for operator replacements, only 10% of the variants does crash. By far, operator replacements are the type of edits that lead to the most fitness improvement. However, this is also the edit types that lead to the most loss in fitness. Finally, within the edits with the same fitness as the previous sequence of edit, roughly half of them show the show an identical output. Finally, we have a look at the coupling between edit types and ingredient type. These three graphs show, for the deletion, replacement, and insertion operators, the performance relatively to the type of statement on which they operate. Gray bars represent cases in which a fitness is not worse, meaning that program behavior should be mostly preserved, and blue bars show cases in which the edit is useful at passing more test cases. For all three operators, the least useful ingredient type is declaration statement, and the most useful is the expression statement. We also note that for deletion, targeting if conditions and while loops was very efficient. But as mentioned before, none of these edits did make it to the final patches. At last, we show the statistics for the comparison operator replacements. We can see that equality, in blue, and inferior, in yellow, were the comparison operators the most present in the targeted programs, and that replacing less or equal, in orange, with any other operator, was the more efficient. But overall, there is no clear pattern. In our experiment, we investigated how gedits are generated, most frequently in two steps, first selecting an edit type and then sampling the genetic material. We show that selecting edit types uniformly lead to overrepresentation of small edit species. Our results confirm that while this can be beneficial when fixes can be found using those edits, the search process could be improved by considering a better balance between edit types. In particular, we found that, in contrast to previous work, deletions edit were significantly less useful than expected, with none of them present in the final patches of the uniform strategy. As for edit ingredients, statistics gathered during the search showed that not all genetic material was equally useful. This is another point in which the search process can be improved with better guidance. In future work, we want to continue in that direction and propose a better fine-tuned selection strategy. Because the programs of the QuickSpurge benchmark are very short, we want to extend our experiments to larger real-world software to ensure the relevance of the statistical analysis. Finally, we'll expect your results to be different for functional and non-functional genetic improvement. So we want to compare both of them to obtain, in one end, a search process more dedicated to fixing bugs, and on the other end, a search process more dedicated to improve, for example, the software running time or the software memory consumption.